Linux Mint is known for its simplicity, but simplicity doesn't have to be boring. Mint's Thinman desktop is actually capable of pretty neat customization. You just have to put in some time and effort. So in this video, I'll share various elements you can customize in the Linux Mint Cinnamon desktop to get a neat, dope looking desktop like the one I'm showing here. Let's start with the obvious, changing the themes and icons. You can install themes from Cinnamon Store, but there are not that many options available. You can go to Plin website and look into Cinnamon Corner, or you can install a GTK theme and it should normally work in Cinnamon too. Just to be sure, check the theme page or look into the extracted theme folder to see if it has a folder for Cinnamon. I'll share the links of the themes and icons that I have used here in the description. Next, let's download some beautiful fonts too. My current favorite is JetBrains Mono. The next step is to extract these files and put them in their right places. The extracted theme may have several variants. Treat them like individual themes. Copy these folders and now go to your home directory and press Ctrl H to show hidden files and folders. If it doesn't exist already, create a new folder named .themes. The dot is important. Paste the copied themes files here. Do the same with icons and fonts. Extract the icon files. If there are subfolders, copy them individually and then go to your home directory. Create .icons folders if it is not there already and paste the icons you copied. It's the same process for fonts too. Just put them in .fonts folder in your home directory. Now that we have the themes and icons files in the places, let's switch to these new ones. Open the Themes tool, go to Advanced Settings, then under Applications, change the theme to Catfishing. Next, change the icons too. You can find the ones you installed earlier at the top. You can also download a different mouse cursor theme and put it in the .icons folder and then use it from here. I'm happy with the current cursor theme. Also, change the desktop theme element. Things are already looking different, don't they? Now, to change the font, open the font selection tool and use JetBrains. Before we move further, let me thank our sponsor,
Warp Terminal. Warp is a modern, Rust-based terminal app with built-in AI agent to help you boost productivity as a dev or DevOps with a modern IDE-like user experience. You can use ChatGPT or DeepSeek in it. It can also be integrated with VS Code. Link to try Warp is in the description.
Next, I'm going to customize the bottom panel to make it smaller. It is optional, but I would recommend that, because I want to use plank dock here, which gives a minimalist look. So let's remove these applets. Right-click on the far right Show Desktop buttons and remove the corner bar. Right-click on an empty place in the panel and select Applets. Here, enable the Workspace Switcher applet and go to its settings and change the type of display to Simple Buttons. You can download more applets as you like. Like, I installed this CineMenu applet, a customizable menu applet. Enable the CineMenu applet from the applet tools and go to its settings by clicking the setting button beside the applet. Go to the Behavior tab and enable Use Menu Animations. Also disable the Activate Categories on click. Now in Search tab, change the web search option to DuckDuckGo or Brave or something which you like. If you want, you can also change the panel icon. Look at the bottom right to see the changes. Reduce the icon size and remove the panel text so that it only shows the icon. Okay, so we have two menu buttons. Let's remove the classic one to use only CineMenu. Now, right-click the panel and toggle the panel edit mode button. Drag and drop items on the panel to the left, right, or central zone as you like. I'll go with the left one. Let me drag the workspace switcher to the left as well. Once done, right-click on an empty space in the panel and toggle off the panel edit mode. You can change the desktop icon's behavior too. I prefer keeping it clean, so I remove all the icons from the desktop. If you like, You can move the panel to the top or left or right by clicking empty places in the panel and selecting move. Let's add some more customizations with a few extensions like transparent panels and burn my windows. Enable transparent panels from the extension manage page by selecting it and clicking the plus sign at the bottom. Then access its settings, change the transparency to semi or full transparent. See the impact on the top of the screen. Similarly, enable burn my windows extension. You can see that windows animations have changed now. You can further change the window animation as you like. It's really up to you. Let's install Plank now. And while you do that, also subscribe to this channel. This will also help you because I'll be sharing more Linux customization tutorials right here. Do subscribe. Now, ensure that Plank starts automatically on each boot. Start startup applications. Click on the plus button and select choose application. From the list, select Plank and click Add Application. Next, it's time to customize Plank. Open Plank, hold Control key, and right-click on Plank to select Preferences. Here, change the theme to transparent. Reduce the icon size, enable icon zoom, and set a value as you need. It controls the ripple effect as you hover the icons. Now, let's talk about wallpapers. I advise keeping your wallpapers in the dedicated folder in Pictures instead of using them directly from Downloads, because if you delete them, and they will be gone. While you can just leave it like that, I did something else here. First, I set the background color to black, and then I edited a wallpaper to 1920x1000 instead of 1080 to get a black background around top and bottom. This makes things look better. Then I changed the picture aspect value to centered to give it the intended look. A few more changes. Search for Windows in the Start menu and go to the Alt+Tab section. Change the Alt+Tab switcher style to Timeline. Enable Show Windows from All Workspaces if you want that. Now, Linux Mint uses this Shed as the default text editor. And there's Catpachin theme available for the Shed editor too. Go to the GitHub repository of the project and download the theme file. Open Shed, go to Edit, Preferences, Theme, and change the theme to Catpachin. Almost there, I promise. Cinnamon allows the use of desklets. Search for desklet in the Start menu and go to the Download section. Install the Timelet desklet. Now come to the Manage page, enable Timelet desklet, and access its settings. Change the theme to Gotham, disable the 24-hour clock, and change the background color to transparent. Scale the desklet to a convenient size as per your choice. And we are there. I know it took some time and effort, but the effort is paid off when you see the end result. It's a work of beauty, right? Add the customized terminal that I shared a few weeks back, and you will have a dope looking system without even switching to Arch Linux. That's something, right? I'll let you enjoy the beauty and simplicity of Linux Mint Cinnamon while I see you in our next video. Stay subscribed, stay Linuxing, enjoy.